Thanks for watching. I'm meteorologist Jacqueline Thomas. Heading through the start of our weekend, we had some clouds in place today. A few spots got a quick little snow shower early this morning. And as we head through the rest of our weekend, we are going to see fairly quiet conditions, a little breeze at times. High temperatures today did touch 40 degrees in some spots. And the average now, the normal high this time of year, is in the low 40s. So just starting to get more and more closer to spring. Satellite and radar showing what's left of the clouds still overhead as we head into the evening hours, but that system continues to depart and then we'll be left with a bit more sunshine as we head into tomorrow. So tonight we stay mainly cloudy initially, and then we do turn partly cloudy as we head into tomorrow morning. Lows tonight fall back into the teens up north and 20s as you head further south, but we're also springing forward this weekend. Of course, this evening, the sunset happening before 6 p.m., just around quarter of, but by tomorrow evening, the sunset will be happening just before 7 p.m., around 10 of. So, of course, we gain that hour of daylight at the end of the day, but we lose that hour of daylight in the morning time with those differences in the sunrise happening later as well. But we're springing forward, another sign that spring is inching ever so closer. Tomorrow, temperatures get back into the 40s across most of the state, so it is going to be a mild Sunday for us. It will be a little breezy at times, but we do at least get back into some sun. And of course, the sun angle a little bit stronger now this time of year too, so it feels a little better. Heading into the start of the week on Monday, we still get a fairly quiet start to the day on Monday. We'll see some clouds thickening up quickly as the day goes on. Temperatures Monday will likely reach the 30s far north and some 40s south, all ahead of our next storm system. And we do now have a winter storm watch in effect for all areas there shaded in blue. That includes the Conway area down through the Lakes region, the Monadnock region from Jaffrey up through Concord as well. As you head southeast in the state, closer to the coast, there is no watch issued there yet, for we are expecting a little bit of mixing to take place in those areas. And then far north across Coos County, you likely could see some lesser totals too. So what are we talking about with this next system? Well, the areas that you see here in this watch have a good potential for several inches of snowfall with this next system, perhaps even as much as a foot or more possible in some of these areas. So that's the type of snow that we have to keep an eye on here. The timing arrives late Monday, lasts through Tuesday into early Wednesday. So here's what we've got. Here's what we know so far and what we don't know. Heavy snow likely at times with this system. Messy travel is definitely expected. And with this storm system too, we'll likely get some stronger winds. This will be more of a classic nor'easter. The thing that we don't know yet is really those exact snow totals. But again, several inches of snow are likely statewide, especially away from the immediate coast. And those areas in the watch that I pointed out have the best chance of, at least right now, the best chance of potentially seeing a foot or more of snow from this system, which is something we'll be keeping our eyes on. So here's the future cast as we head through Tuesday. This area of low pressure continues to track near the shore. Of course, the track of this we'll have to keep an eye on too, because a shift further west could mean more by way of mixing or milder air getting in here. Whereas too, if it stays just off to our east, then we'll be on the colder side of that system and we likely get all snow for many areas with this storm. Long duration nor'easter possible, heavy snow, some mixing right at the coast, and again, some strong gusty winds, which could lead to some potential power outages too as we head through the early part of the week. So a lot to watch in these next couple of days. Remember, we spring forward 2 a.m. technically overnight into tomorrow, and then to start the week, that system moves in with some quieter conditions towards the end of the week as we head towards St. Patrick's Day.